Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in this video today, I'm going to be showing you how to basically transform a static image into one that has a little bit of motion baked into it, kind of like that 3D or parallax type of effect. And it's actually really easy to do. So there's a few ways that you can do this. You can use some online tools, and I linked to them in a recent Medium post. I'll link to this in the description. It also covers basically everything in this video if you want to read through it step by step. Or you can actually create it using Automatic 1111's Web UI or Forge. And in today's video, I'm gonna be using Forge, but steps are gonna be the same for Automatic 1111 Web UI. But we're gonna be using the depth map script. So you can actually find that if you go to your extensions and go to available, and you might need to click script. I can't remember off the top of my head, but then you'll just go ahead and search for depth map script. And then once it's installed, you'll see it here, the depth map script. And you're just gonna wanna go ahead and make sure that you apply and restart the UI. And once that's done, you'll have this little depth tab that'll be at the top of the interface here. So this is kind of a straightforward interface here, but one of the most important things to note right away is that this doesn't use any sort of diffusion model. It's using depth mapping models like Midas and such. So you aren't, what you set as your checkpoint doesn't really matter here, nor does the image dimensions as well. But to kind of demonstrate how to do this, we're just going to go ahead and take in our static image here, and then we will go ahead and set the depth map model that we want to use. So I'm just going to use Midas here, but there's lots to choose from, and whichever one you end up clicking to download or generate, it will go ahead and download it to your models directory, and then it will go ahead and create a depth map of this image. So let me just go ahead and just click that real quick. Okay, so here's the depth output. If you've worked with control nets, you've probably seen this before, but basically it kind of calculates what it believes to be the depth of the image, what the foreground objects are, and what the background objects are. And as you can see, it took about 20 seconds. And just for reference, this is running off a RTX 3060, 12 gigabytes of VRAM. So you can kind of use that as a benchmark for what you might expect for processing times. So to create that sort of image with the motion, all you need to do is go to this Generate 3D and Painted Mesh. And once you click that, it's a very slow generation process. So I'll skip ahead, but before I do, I just want to show you that there's also this Generate 4 demo videos with 3D and Painted Mesh. And I highly recommend to check that if you want to see four different variations. And I'll also show you in just a second what the settings are. But if we go ahead and take a look at this static image, this is the swing one. It's kind of like a side-to-side type of motion here. And then there's a circle. As you can see, it kind of goes around in a circle and zooms in and zooms out a little bit. And then there's just the classic zoom in straight towards the horizon. And then lastly, there's the dolly zoom in. So those are the four basically effects that you'll get whenever you generate the four demo videos. Just for the sake of time, I'm going to skip it in this demonstration, because to generate the 3D and painted mesh, it takes about 5 minutes. And so I'll go ahead and create that. But if I do also the four demo videos, it's about a minute or so, between 30 seconds and a minute per video. So just for time's sake, I'm going to skip it. But if you're doing this for the first time, I'd recommend to set that there. So I'm going to go ahead and just click generate here, and then we'll have an output here in the 3D mesh that will show basically a representation of this image. So let's go ahead and get that generated and then skip ahead to the once that's done. Okay, so after a few minutes here, we now have our 3D representation of the image based on the depth output. It's not really useful to us at this point, but that's what just created over those past few minutes. But it creates this depth mapped object. So you can, you only have to do this once, and that's really important, because if you want to go ahead and generate a video, all it needs is this reference file. And all of these files here, I'll show you where they're located. So you can find them once you go to your outputs. They're going to be in the extra images folder here, and you'll see the OBJ files. And as you can see, they can be quite large. Some of them are about up to 400 megs. Yeah, it's not something you want to keep doing time and again for every depth video that you want to create, but you can go ahead and reuse the objects. But since I didn't do a video at all, we can actually play with some of these. And I put in the parameters within this. So if we want to create the dolly zoom in effect, I'm just going to go ahead and copy this and put it into the translate. And I'm going to enable dolly. And then it is a double straight line right there. So then this will go ahead and create 300 frames with a frame rate of 40. So I'm going to just go ahead and click generate video. And while that processes, I just wanted to quickly touch on is that this 3D mesh object, as you can see, it's a .obj file. And I'm not too familiar with Blender, but I believe it's a popular format with that particular application to create 3D files. And whenever reading through the documentation, somewhere in here, the author here was saying that you can't really use Blender files. I can't remember where I saw that. Because I guess there's information baked into those .obj files that is relevant to this extension. You might want to just double check that, but I could have swore I read that somewhere here. So just to keep that in mind, that you'll have to use these depth map files. And so after about 52 seconds, we now have our hopefully dolly zoom in type of effect, which it does look like. And there we go. We just created a 3D type of parallax image from a static image using this depth map extension, which is really cool. Now there are a few key points that I want to also share in some of the demos that I was doing yesterday with this. And so I tried a few different subjects and scenes to kind of see what the limitations are for this. So here's the first one, and this is the biggest downside to it, is going to be portraits. So I did a close-up of a person here, and as you can see, there's a lot of tearing in the screen, especially like along their hair. We can see that a lot of the elements are all lost and it doesn't look that good. So you want to make sure that you never have a subject too close within, to the viewer, if you will, because it just tears a lot with these sorts of animations. Even this dolly zoom in one, which looks the best out of all of them, at the start of it looked pretty bad. So just keep that in mind. So what you want to do is, in this demonstration, I have a subject where it's like a medium shot, and we can see it looks a lot better than the previous one. Although, that sort of side to side motion is a little bit too much. Same with the circle, but if we do like the zoom ins, it looks a lot better and a lot more natural. And it can create a cool effect. There are little things like his watch here. You can see at the start of that it tears a little bit. But still though, the further away basically the subject is from the camera, if you will, or from the viewer, it will give you better results. So just to keep in mind. Here's one that I thought turned out pretty cool, was this anime type of scene, where it really creates a kind of like a compelling scene, and there's no real noticeable like tearing that's going on during this animation. But again though, if you kind of use that swing or circle, it starts to get lost, where like her hood here is getting really stretched out and looks a little weird. But like just a subtle zoom in and such, it looks pretty cool. So yeah, that's kind of it with the depth map. I hope that this video is helpful and it can create some really cool pictures, whether it's on Instagram or whatever, Reddit and so on. But create some neat outputs and something worth definitely exploring. So if you have any questions about it, drop a line in the comments below or check out that Medium post if you want to kind of read a little bit more in depth that goes on the outside of this video. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.